will start with finite state machines. So as part of computing models, the very first mission or model is finite state machine or finite state automaton. So to understand the finite state automaton and subsequently push down automaton, Turing machine and so on, we need a framework. We need to understand a certain notation and preliminaries to understand how this machine works. And essentially, we are trying to understand how a machine is trying to compute a certain task. So look at human-human interaction. So when there is an interaction between two human beings, it could be between two Indians or between an Indian and a Chinese. So naturally, when you establish a communication between two human beings, you need a medium for communication. That's precisely our language. It's natural language, so it could be English, or it could be German, it could be Japanese, so it could be any language, depending upon what these two are comfortable with. So when you talk about a language, there are a couple of things to note. So there is something called alphabet, and with the help of alphabet, you construct something called words, then sentences, paragraphs, and so on. Like this, it goes, right? And then it becomes paragraphs, and so on. And we also define something called rules or grammar that says how these words have to be combined and what rules or grammar that one should follow when we speak a sentence. And similarly, when we write a paragraph consisting of many statements, sentences, how should one write, what rules one should follow, the grammar, all that is prescribed as part of natural language. Now, on the similar line, now we are trying to establish a communication between human and a machine, or machine to machine. So it could be human machine interaction, or it could be machine to machine. You can call it as machine to machine interaction or machine to machine communication, and this machine could be computers. So you can call it as human computer interaction, computer computer interaction, and it could be any machine. Fine. So if this is going to be the focus, then naturally there is a language associated with this. So what is that language? Which means we talk about alphabet, we talk about grammar. Fine. So if you look at, say, a natural language, for example, the English, when you make a statement like, say, India is a country. Now, this is our statement. This statement that India is a country, you can see that it can be parsed into sub statements. So when you parse this, you get something called noun phrase and verb phrase. Below that, you get noun or proper noun. And below this, you get to see verb. something called article. Sometimes you may find adjectives also, then followed by a noun. So this is telling you that below this you assign India, below this you assign S, followed by country. This one is called parse tree, corresponding to the statement India is a country. So things like this you will come across in any natural language, and you may have some more things like adjective, preposition and so on. So according to the statement, the tree changes and the label that you associate with will also change. Okay. And so the point is, you come up with any statement or sentence in a particular language, say English, you get to see a tree like this, which we call it as parse tree. So like this, we will have parse tree, language, grammar, all that with respect to the language that we will be discovering for human machine interaction and mission to mission interaction. In particular, when you think of any mission, human beings are missions, because we are processing unit, we process, and when somebody speaks, we can recognize, and we recognize, understand what they speak, and then we respond. So which means we have processing capabilities. So on the similar line, you think of a mission, for example, finite state automaton, and what is the fundamental thing, say alphabet, and subsequently words, sentences, how are we going to form sentences, what are all the rules, grammars, and all this constitute so-called mission language. And now, given an arbitrary sentence or a statement, following this rule, we do parsing. Because our rule says, you look at any sentence or a statement, you can decompose them into noun phrase and verb phrase. So subsequently, you get the components like verb, article, noun, and all that. So on the similar line, can we define the framework for finite state machines? Fine. So that's precisely our focus. If you consider any natural language, in particular, say the English, you have something called sigma, which we call it as alphabet. Alphabet consisting of symbols A, B, C, so on up to this, then small this, then we have 0, 1, so on up to 9. Something like this is there. Now you can even separate this and then have this as part of alphabet. This comes as part of numbers. But just for my convenience, I'm combining all of them. So now you try framing words. For example, alphabet itself, and if you look at the word alphabet, you see that this is a symbol belonging to sigma. You look at any one, it is a symbol belonging to this. And each one is a symbol, and in particular, this one is a word, something called string. So it is a string over sigma, which means I define something called sigma star, which is set of all strings over sigma. For example, sigma star consisting of each symbol is also a string or a word. You can have a and the and India, course, and so on. Now when we speak sentences, we pick strings or words from this. Now you may pick a word W1, W2, W3 and W4. Now in what order I should speak and whether W3 should come after W2 and how should I make sentences having many words, all that is given by grammar or rules. Correct? And when we look at a statement or a sentence, you look at an arbitrary statement or a sentence, we say so-and-so statement is grammatically correct. So we say so-and-so statement is grammatically correct, which means it's a valid statement as far as the language English is concerned. Or we say it is grammatically incorrect, or it is an invalid statement as far as this language is concerned. So, as per the defined rules, this statement is valid. And as per defined rules, this statement is invalid. So now something similar to this, we are going to define an alphabet for finite state machine. We are going to generate strings over sigma. And we shall define grammars using which you can combine a couple of words to form sentences. And when do you say a statement or a sentence is valid? And when do you say it is invalid? Okay, so all that we shall be discussing now. Sigma is alphabet. It may consist of 0, 1, or it may consist of say A comma B, or it may consist of A, B, C, some special symbol like dollar, blank, and things like this. So each one is called symbol. And sigma is referred to as alphabet. Then we define something called sigma star, which is strings over sigma. For example, if sigma is A comma B, then we define, starting from this, strings of length 0 and no string at all. When you say strings of length 0, so but this is a symbol using which we denote. This is called epsilon. This epsilon denotes empty string. So some textbooks, they follow this, something similar to lambda, but we follow this. Now strings of length 1 is A and B. Strings of length 2 is AA, AB, BA, BB. Now strings of length 3 is AAA, AB, BAB, and so on. So now all of this is part of sigma star. you will find strings of length 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and you ask for strings of length k, all of them will be present here. Then we define something called a language denoted using the symbol L, and language L is precisely a subset of sigma star, which means L is a subset of sigma star. So you say you have designed a finite state automaton accepting language L. What does that mean? It is accepting strings that are present in alpha, sorry, that are present in L, which is a subset of sigma star. And it may not recognize or accept everything in sigma star. It may accept only a subset of it. That subset we call it as a language. So what is a language? Language is some subset of sigma star. So now with this framework, we will start constructing finite state machines. And what is the description of the machine? How you look at a problem, or how do you approach the problem when you start designing finite state machines? And where do we come across finite state machines in computer science? All that we shall discuss next.